Be positive, not negative. 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 I'm trying my best here, people. I really am. And today I bring you the latest news surrounding the game, which has came out of the Thursday news update for Outriders. How's it going, guys? My name is DPJ, and if you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really helps out. And if you like what you see and want to see more, be sure to subscribe. Okay, so earlier today we got a little dev news update, Thursday's dev news for Outriders, where they discuss wider changing and further balancing, including legendary sets. They also talk about the patch, which I do believe now will come out probably early next week, and we'll talk about all the changes that comes with that as well. But let's get straight into their general news and the actual changes to legendary sets and a few other bits and bobs. Okay, so general news. Our latest patch is currently in the final stages of the first party submission process. We know that this has been a long process, but we are confident that we are nearing the proper release of this patch and are hoping to get it out in the very near future. Okay, so they talk about, like I said, further balancing, including those legendary sets. So let's get into that. We did want to thank everyone for their thoughts regarding last week's topic for discussion, Fortress. The team has been avidly watching the discussions unfold and are considering all reasonable feedback. There was some understandable consternation regarding the intended changes, so we wanted to confirm and reiterate the following. Fortress will not be changed in isolation. The changes will be implemented as part of a much bigger update across Outriders, which will include a slew of other buffs to legendary armor sets, other mods, and the class trees. The bigger update, which is still a little while away, is also planned to make significant improvements to other aspects of Outriders and will bring Stadia in line with all other platforms. Well, that's about time. We also have additional ideas for further buffs should they be needed, but we are confident that the upcoming rebalance will be enough to leave players feeling just as powerful as before, but with a greater diversity of options to choose from. We do not plan to address the issues of either Fortress or Morrowinds before we have resolved the challenges that drove the creation of this meta and that continue to require its viability. You therefore do not need to worry about other disruptive changes to the current power balance, as long as the overall end-to-end endgame experience exists in its current form. With that said, we want to share some details around the legendary army reworking that has been going on behind the scenes. Bear in mind that the changes to legendary sets are still subject to further internal balancing testing, but we hope you'll find these planned changes exciting as we do. Okay, so Devastator, the Marshal. The set bonus of Marshal set will have its shared bonus derived from anomaly damage increased to 40%, previously 10%. The Marshal Gloves armor set, Marshal's Gauntlets, will have its mod swapped. The Shattered Armor mod will be replaced with the Mosh Pit mod. The Shattered Armor mod removes armor from enemies, while the Mosh Pit mod applies the status effect vulnerability. As the Marshal gear is more of an anomaly power set, we decided it was a better fit to increase damage from all sources instead of reducing enemy armor. Okay, so Death Proof. A new set bonus will be added to the existing bonus. The existing bonus is reduce the cooldown of Boulder Dash by 90%. The additional new set bonus will be reduce the cooldown of Boulder Dash by 90% and increase firepower by 15% of armor. So that's not bad. The Death Proof Gloves armor set piece, Death Proof Gauntlets, has had its mod swapped. The Kingslayer mod will be replaced with the Death Doors mod. Statue. The statue set will have its attributes swapped. The skill leech attribute will be replaced with a close range damage attribute. Okay, so onto Pyromancer. The Lava Leech set. The set bonus of the Lava Leech set will have its cooldown reduction it provides increased to 30%. It was previously 10%. Reforged set. Reforged was originally intended to be a long range firepower set. However, players have mostly used it with anomaly power builds. We will therefore change the attributes of this set to better support anomaly damage builds. The long range attributes on all set pieces will be changed for either a cooldown reduction or a skill leech attribute. The Reforged Head Armor set piece, the Cowl of the Reforged, will have its attribute swapped. The health attribute will be replaced with an anomaly power attribute. The long range attribute will be replaced with either a cooldown reduction or a skill leech attribute. This change makes the helmet more suitable to the set's new functionality of an anomaly power oriented build. The Forge chest armor set piece, armor of the Forge, will have its mod swapped. The Bully absorption mod will be replaced with the Ash grass mod, which inflicts ash on all enemies in thermal bomb's area of effect range prior to its explosion. This should make thermal bomb much easier to use as part of this set. The Reforged lower armor set piece, the waistcloth of the Reforged, will have its mod swapped. The Wildfire mod has been replaced with the Fire Frenzy mod, which provides an additional use of thermal bomb. The Reforged Feet armor set, the boots of the Reforged, will have its mod swapped. The Nova Master mod will be replaced with the Anomaly Hunger mod. By making this change, we expect to feed the flame skill to deal more damage, making it a better tool to detonate thermal bombs. The set bonus of the Reforged set will have its damage bonus increased to 75%. Using thermal bomb increases the next damage of the Feed the Flames by 75%. It was previously 50%. Using Feed the Flames increases damage of next thermal bomb by 75%. This was also previously 50%. Okay, so now we are onto the Trickster, the Trespasser set. A new set bonus will be added to the existing bonus. The existing bonus is player characters inside Slow Trap cannot die. The new additional bonus will be increases damage by 6% per enemy affected by a deception skill. Additionally, players cannot die inside the slow trap. Note, deception skills are slow trap, finesse knife and time rift. I've already got some amazing combinations in my head going around, let me tell ya. Okay, so we're on to the Technomancer. Torrential Downpour set. The extra cluster bomb swap by the set bonus of the Torrential Downpour will have their deployment time reduced. A bug that is preventing an extra mine's deployment after a direct hit will also be fixed. Grim Inventor set. The set bonus of Grim Inventor set has been changed so that Tools of Destruction will be able to be refilled multiple times during its duration. The old set bonus is, while Tools of Destruction is active, a confirmed hit with Pain Launcher refills 20% ammunition for both Minigun and the RPG. This only happens once for each Tool of Destruction usage. New set bonus will be, while Tools of Destruction is active, a confirmed hit with Pain Launcher refills 20% of the ammunition for both the Minigun and the RPG. So that's pretty cool too. And those are the changes coming to the Legendary set. People, so there's quite some decent changes there, I'm not gonna lie. Now the patch, which like I said earlier, I do believe will come out early next week, Thursday by latest, this is what they say on that. Our latest patch is currently working its way through the first party submission cycle, but we wanted to share some highlights of the upcoming fixes and changes with you already today. But blah 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 blah, they say this every time, but these are what are supposedly coming with this next patch. Further improved the visibility of the Broodmother Surge area of effect skill limits. Fixed a bug that was preventing players from reviving themselves and other players after using the Trickster Bold Time skill. Resolved an issue that could cause the game to stutter when engaging crawlers in battle during expeditions. Resolved an issue that could cause players to stutter when entering the Drain Lake during the third enemy encounter in the Scorched Lands expedition. Resolved an issue that prevented secondary characters from picking up journal entries if they had already been collected on a different character. Resolved an issue that would force matchmaking privacy settings to default to open. The privacy settings should now remain closed when set. This should help further reduce AFK matchmaking. Adding an AFK status for players and friends lists. Change the behaviour of the Devastators in Impale, so that the game will detect impaled enemies as dead even before they disappear. The Devastator's Reflect Bullet skill will now protect from scarf and projectile attacks. Fixed a bug that could prevent Devastators from being able to consistently dodge if they had the auto reflect mod active. Fixed a bug that could cause client shots to sometimes deal no damage to enemies. Fixed a bug that could cause the Technomancer's Plague Sour set to not proc consistently. Fixed a bug that could cause the Plague Sour and the Cannibal Legendary sets to not retain their set bonus after a transition. Fixed a bug that could cause certain mods like Grand Opening not to proc if the player was on their last magazine. Fixed a bug that could cause certain ammo related mods to retain their effects, even after having been replaced. This issue would previously resolve itself when returning to the lobby. Affected mods included Brain Eater, Clip of Iron Malfia, Perpetual Mobile, Vampiric Mag and Reforging Bullets. Crash fixes and other minor bug fixes, people. And that is it for the patch, and this is it guys for the Thursday dev news surrounding Outriders. Now, I know this game hasn't got a massive following like it once had. I know a lot of people have just given up on it. I know a lot of people are just waiting for new content. And hopefully, guys, we have news of that very soon indeed. But we will see. We will see. But on that note, the end of the video has arrived. If you enjoyed it, leaving a like really helps out. If you're new around here and want to see more, be sure to subscribe. And if you never want to miss a video I upload, you can turn notifications on by hitting that bell button. But guys, thanks as always for stopping by, and hopefully I will see you on that next one.